Hi, my name is Franco Rotoli, and I'm a learning experience expert on the Solidworks training team. Today's tip is one that I use every day. We all know how valuable the measure tool is in Solidworks. Today, I'm going to show you a faster way to access some of the information that the measure tool gives us. Let's jump into Solidworks and take a look. Here, I have a picnic table assembly, though this tip works for both parts and assemblies. We know that the measure tool on the Evaluate toolbar is extremely flexible. By clicking an edge, I can easily get the length. Clicking a face gives me the surface area and perimeter. Clicking a vertex gives me the X, Y, Z coordinates based on the origin. Selecting multiple items by holding the Control key gives me even more information, like angle, total area, total perimeter, total length, and more. Sometimes I don't need all that information. Sometimes I just want the length of an edge. For example, if I want a tablecloth for this table, and I quickly want to know the minimum length I need to buy, I can just click this edge. And down in the status bar, SOLIDWORKS will instantly tell you the length. When I click two angled edges or faces, it gives me the angle between them, instantly giving me the most common uses of the measure tool. While we're down here looking at the status bar, let's not forget the units system shortcut. This shortcut quickly changes the document units between the most common standards. For more unit options, I'll click Edit Document Units, and it will take me to the Document Properties section of the SOLIDWORKS options. By changing the units here, it will change the units of the status bar measurements. So next time you need a quick measurement, remember that the SOLIDWORKS status bar is there for you. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, click the link in the description below to access additional tips, tricks, and training courses. And as always, happy modeling.